Welcome everyone to another episode of Magnation Blue. And as you saw, Magneto in the gigantic wheel, there will be some matches tonight. We have elimination qualifier matches. This is the first one right here, Wolverine versus Jason Voorhees. And we're going to be having a Royal Rumble type event as well.
Nice. Winner, 10 man?
I'm going to step up a little bit and make it a 20 man.
20 man?
Wow. I am excited.
Magneto, you're my boy, but sometimes the land of opportunity has got to grow a little bit.
Of course.
Exactly. Right. Although I do like his original concept, but this is the first match, Jason versus Wolverine. Winner gets into the Elimination Chamber match for the Magnation Blue title at the next pay-per-view.
The Rabid Wolverine.
Yes.
Wolverine.
And here he comes now, the Rabid Wolverine.
Five Woo. Names, three of them Wolverine.
Wolverine, the Rabid Wolverine.
Yes.
All right, that's six now.
Four.
I don't know. Almost as bad as Quan Cheadles.
Quan Cheadles.
Wolverine on a little bit of a losing streak, losing the Magnation Blue Championship at Space Jam and then losing a triple threat match to Loki last week. So hopefully he'll get back on track here.
Hopefully.
Because he does have a weakened Jason.
A weakened Jason?
Because Jason got the shit kicked out of him last week.
Damn.
He got beaten up really good in that Money in the Bank
match. Oh god, that match was horrific.
That match was amazing.
It was a great match.
So we'll see if Jason can heal up from that, because that was just punishing on everyone involved.
Well, some hopefully, you know, these next few matches can compare to Magnation's Dream ladder match main event.
That's true.
Was on this Monday.
That was a solid match.
Let's hope so.
Kazuya coming out on top of that one.
Story of his life, though, I'll tell you that much. There's Magnation Blue.
He wins when it matters, except for that one time he didn't.
That's right, the pay-per-view. Anyway, here we go. Here comes Jason Voorhees.
Yes.
My all-time favorite.
An emotional favorite to win the title.
Horror movie villain.
Okay. We'll see if he can finally get it done here by winning this match. Because he did win the Galactic Championship in an Elimination Chamber, beating Jack Six.
Jack Six.
Well, he's been going a while. We haven't seen him in a while.
He's a powerhouse.
Or right Boo, back. Or...
We haven't seen him, Boo, Marcus Phoenix.
We haven't seen Bojack. He hasn't been fired. He just hasn't been around.
Yeah.
Well, Phoenix too.
Well, I don't know. He's just like so random, like, throwing to the series, the movies.
Here you go.
Like you said, the first thing he says is it's been a while since they broke somebody's neck.
Greatest thing of all time.
So.
That is a solid way to fucking introduce yourself.
Now, we don't have Broly. Play the Magnation thing, or do we?
He used to be here.
I think that might need to change.
Maybe.
Fantastic.
Might need to change. Anybody want to make Broly? Because I really don't want to do
Somebody
it.
Somebody probably has already.
Let's find him. I'll find him.
Yeah.
And I will.
And here we go. This is just a regular singles match.
And you can see Jason just towers over Wolverine.
Absolutely. Now, I wanted to make sure this match happened because to break the fourth wall. When I was trying to make Space Jam, it was an absolute atrocity to try to get that title match to happen.
Okay.
So much so that you couldn't make a title match without one of the four CAWs coming out in just stock default gear. So I was like, alright, well, what if I do a tournament between Loki, Jason, Wolverine, and...
Oh, what a spine buster!
And Ash Ketchum, and the winner of that gets the title. So I had Jason versus Wolverine, and it was an awesome match. I was like, I'm going to do it again. But as you saw, I was able to get it to where I could have four of them in the ring at the same time.
Excellent.
Fantastic.
Yeah. That pay-per-view was such a pain in the balls to do. Super Nova, way easier.
Oh, well, that was much easier.
Yeah, but I think Space Jam had a really high turnout, didn't it?
It did.
For you guys?
It did.
I think a lot of...
It yielded positive results.
So now, are you guys going to recycle pay-per-view names, or are you going to come up with new ones?
We gotta recycle them. I can't. I have a hard time coming up with three.
We have to. We're gonna recycle the ones that have already happened.
Well, yeah.
Hell of a spear by Jason there. But the ones that, like, obviously where there's a gap to fill.
Right.
We're gonna have to make up with.
Like, Galactic Throwdown is our WrestleMania, pretty much, right?
Yeah. Galactic right. Throwdown and Mega Mania are two. Big Bang, also one of the big ones.
Gotcha.
Because we've already had two of each of those.
And now we've had Supernova too.
Yep.
Okay then.
Correctamundo.
Correct. Huge spine buster by Jason. Now this is just going to be a war here between these two.
Wolverine not even mounting any offense yet. Okay, headbutt to the shoulder.
Oh, he'll get there.
Of Jason.
Hey, who you got in this matchup, Shadow? Oh, my God!
I'm going to go Jason. As I said, he is my favorite horror movie character. And I've always been a big, big fan.
Mr. Magnitude, what would you like to...
Definitely Wolverine. Even though I hate Wolverine, I just want to see him do something.
I know. This is a brawler's match right here.
Adamantium punches.
That's right.
The Adamantium.
And oh, man!
Spine buster of his own.
Sky high. Making D.O. Brown proud.
D.O. Brown.
Former member of the Aces and Eights.
Wow, he just knocked him out.
Ever remember
the undead, that. The undead monster that is Jason Voorhees. Just tossing Wolverine out of the...
A drop kick by Jason!
Wow.
That's...
Well, looks like his knees are healed up a little bit.
Freddie Jones starting to count.
Maybe he pulled the Diamond Dallas Page and wrapped him in Saran Wrap. I swear to God, that was a story.
That's an interesting story.
Oh, yeah, it was one of those nights where, you know, how wrestlers travel on the road, and we had Mick Foley, Stone Cold Steve Austin, and DDP sharing a hotel room.
Stop in a mud hole in the Wolverine.
DDP goes a shower, and this is when Stone Cold and Mankind decide to fuck with DDP. So they short sheet DDP's bed, and in between the covers, just put an entire pan of chocolate chip cookies that a fan had given Mick Foley at some point during the night. So, at some point, DDP like realizes this has happened to him, and it's like 3 a.m. He just flips out, and he just is like, "Who did this? Who did this?" And suddenly, like, Mick Foley starts like laughing. He's like, "You did this to me!" So he just starts, while stark naked, just jumping on Mick Foley's bed and like mashing cookies into his face and shit. Yeah, that's where it didn't go. But yeah,
wow. The roids.
The roids.
The roids. The roids.
The roids. Who used to make that joke about? Was it Ash?
I think it was Ash.
Thursdays?
Whatever we want, really. I think I might have this go up like Wednesday and then D-League Friday.
Okay. So anyway, I know that. Who picked up Final Fantasy 13 Lightning Returns yesterday? I know I did. And
I did not.
It is fantastic. It is fantastic. The demo was great.
I have not.
Well, maybe you should.
Or maybe I will.
What's it for? Like DS?
No, it's for the Xbox 360 and the PlayStation 4, yes.
Usually I figured that like Final Fantasy just sticks to like DS.
I did too, but 13 changed that, the first one.
Yeah.
And when Jen told me she pre-ordered it for me, I looked at her, I'm like, "What system did you pre-order it for me?" And she goes, "The PlayStation." I go, "Good. Because if you got it for the Xbox, I probably would not play it." I will not play Final Fantasy on the Xbox.
That was a head vice and then threw him down, and Wolverine currently bleeding.
Busted open. But he's got that healing factor, so I don't think it's really going to change much.
Yeah.
One! I'm going to kick out of Wolverine. Wolverine is not going down without a fight.
No.
Look, see, elbows to the face to get Jason to clear some distance. Jason, right back on the assault.
I'm so torn with this match. It's like Wolverine, and like, he has a bit of career renaissance here. It is Jean Grey. A little bit of career renaissance for Wolverine here, but Jason has just been in the Mag Nation for so long.
It's been around for a while.
And for him to be in a title match would be amazing. Oh, could it be? With arms wide open, ready to sunlight. No!
Kick it out.
I had the band queued up. Damn it, Jason.
The band was queued up.
Wolverine now fighting back.
Speaking of Jason being around for a while, his record so far in his time here is 12-8-1.
That's 20, not bad.
21 matches in his career.
And he's only lost once? Or no, eight. He's tied once.
Gotcha. That's still pretty damn good.
That's fantastic.
It is. So it's over 500. Not a lot of people can say they're over 500 because of the fact there are singles, like not all singles matches. And
right. Yeah. Right.
Huge German suplex!
Tossing Wolverine like a ragdoll across the ring.
Now he's stomping a mud hole.
Oh, yeah.
Walking it dry.
Dropping the elbows on the leg, the thigh.
Very sensitive part.
Very, very sensitive. Yes. Even when you have adamantium.
Absolutely.
Your balls still hurt.
I'd imagine.
Elbow to the face. And, wow, what the hell was he dropping the knee on the elbow? Wolverine, healing factor. Big.
Oh, Jesus!
Doesn't help from a Samoan drop.
Samoan drop.
Wolverine needs to get back in this matchup if he wants to mount any kind of comeback here.
Jesus.
Because right now, it has been all Jason for a while.
Indeed, it has been.
Wolverine coming back! Or not.
Now breaking the fourth wall again. Your character is overall 100, correct?
No.
Okay, good, because I don't do that either. I don't think that's fair to have someone be an overall 100 when they're not.
They're ranked between a 93 and a 98.
Okay, fair enough.
Depending on, like, where they are on the card and everything.
Yeah. Recover! 1, 2!
Near fall, by the way. That way there can be upsets and shit like that. Right. So if Mega Man were to beat, like, I don't know, like Jason,
wow,
it would actually be, like, a surprise instead of, like, well, they were both, like, the same.
Right, okay. Yeah, all my characters are in, like, the low 90s, low to mid-90s.
Jason, a little beat up right now. Oh, nice suplex
Wolverine now mounting an offense. Hopefully, it'll be enough to give him the W.
Yes.
The Dubs. Wolverine, you know I hate you.
Grabbing Wolverine getting the Wolverine W.
Now, it would be pretty sweet to see Wolverine in the Elimination Chamber, not going to lie.
It would.
Indeed.
Using the ropes.
Wow!
Backbreaker by Wolverine.
Solid. Punch him in the face.
Using the ropes.
Oh, Jason. Why are you bringing ice cream into my house?
Jason's pissed.
Jason. Wolverine, no. Fighting out again.
Wolverine countering yet again. Wolverine throwing left hand after left hand after left hand.
Strong enough to knock Jason out of the ring.
Adamantium punches. I'm telling you.
Those fists. Throwing those soup bones.
Drop the elbow on the neck, baby.
You think throwing those soup bones?
Yep.
Wolverine grabbing
Steel the stairs alive.
Nope, dropped them.
Are there no DQs?
No, there are DQs.
Interesting concept.
Yeah, that's a ballsy move by Wolverine.
Wolverine's made of metal. He doesn't need steel stairs.
What the fuck's happening?
He just tried to clean her boobies. She woke up.
Honest mistake. Jason.
Shabotsky.
Vintage Shabotsky.
Oh, God.
Oh!
Got him in a torture rack.
That might be it.
That might be it.
Wolverine's tapping.
Wolverine's tapping. Wow, with authority, Jason drops him.
And Jason moves on to face Ash Ketchum, four others in the Elimination Chamber match.
That's looking to be a good match so far.
Solid match so far.
Who's got so far?
Ash Ketchum and Jason.
And then we'll see four other qualifying matches over the next couple weeks.
Fantastic.
And then after that,
shenanigans.
Then those six people have to interact and live in a house together.
Oh, no.
That would actually be pretty cool.
Legends House.
If I was an animator, I'd do that, but I'm not an animator.
Jason and Ash Ketchum living in a house.
Oh, God.
With four other people.
Oh, God.
To be determined.
Yeah, you'll see one more qualifying match tonight.
Okay.
So I think we only have three matches on the card.
All right. Jason, obviously, excited with his victory. Bringing up that win-loss column.
That's right. What is he, 19-8-1? Yeah!
Jason, the powerhouse magnate.
Wait, Jason?
Yeah.
No, he's 13-1.
Oh, he got a 13th win?
13th win, right there.
Oh, I think we should retire him now.
The Friday Night Delight picks up a win.
The Friday Night
Delight. I'm telling you, retire him now. 13, he's at his number.
Yeah. He may never win again.
Oh, I know he might. He probably shouldn't.
And now we have our Royal Rumble match. I did not put a card on there so people can't cheat. No cheating.
Miami Florida.
So here's the number one entrant, Robin.
No cheating.
Nope.
It's Boy Wonder.
So I really have no idea who's coming.
No one does.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Boy Wonder.
This makes it way better.
Rushing into the ring. He's ready to get going.
Hell yeah.
Now what does Wonder get from this, Trevor?
Wonder faces Vegeta at the next pay-per-view.
Wow. That is impressive.
So anyone, obviously, that's in the Royal Rumble or the Elimination Chamber qualifying match
does not get a chance to face Vegeta. Okay.
So if you don't see him here, there's a solid chance they're in Elimination Chamber qualifying.
Right.
Yeah. Magneto just texted me then.
He just texted you? You get text messages from Magneto?
Of course, he's my commish. Gotta stay close.
Aren't you a brown noser?
Well, technically I'm his boss.
Alright, well, is he a brown noser?
We're homies. And number two, who could it be?
Mini Jericho.
Obviously it's Space Ghost.
Mini Jericho.
Everyone's hoping for Mini Jericho.
Dark. Well, because we're not in space. Don't say it. It's Buzz Lightyear.
Yes.
That goddamn face. That goddamn face.
Good luck sleeping tonight. Somewhere in your house, Buzz Lightyear's wandering.
I think if I would ever have a toy of Buzz Lightyear, I would turn the head around if I went to look at the face. Because of these videos.
Have fun sleeping, because somewhere during the night, Buzz Lightyear's going to be giving you a back massage. Don't wake up merely. Sleep right through it.
To Infinity and
Beyond. Oh, he'll take you to Infinity and Beyond.
God damn it, Buzz Lightyear. Where's his wings? Does that happen?
Yeah, they're attracted right now. It's cold. Alright, it's winter.
What? What?
This commentary's gone to a dark place.
This is fantastic.
So, 18 other men will join them.
18 other men! And one woman.
Oh, Wonder Woman. That's badass.
Hawkeye. Beaten up.
I wish I still had the China entrance in the video games. They come out with like a bazooka.
Nice. Buzz Lightyear already trying to eliminate Robin.
Trying to send Robin home early already.
Robin, what? Robin towers over Buzz Lightyear.
Because Buzz Lightyear's a short man.
Yeah, well, look at the
power. Oh!
Look at the power of Robin.
What a DDT!
Drop kicks.
Robin working on Buzz Lightyear in the corner.
That came out wrong.
Wow. Slaps. Oh my God!
Kick to the back of the head. Here comes our third competitor.
Could be anyone!
Could be anybody.
Third competitor, Hawkeye, or Gretel, or Hansel, whatever, whichever one he is.
Hansel, he's so hot right now. Oh, it's Venom!
Showing respect to his lady friend.
Here comes Venom.
Well, now he's
now Venom, trying to move up in the card here. Historically a hardcore wrestler.
Yes.
Oh, he's huge.
Compared to those two, absolutely.
Venom's always been one of my favorites.
So this does not go in the books as any official Royal Rumble.
No.
Because it's only a...
Yes.
Because it's not cross-brand.
Exactly.
Yes.
Just going to make that clear to everybody right now.
Yeah. Make it clear. These don't get added to the overall Royal Rumble stats.
They do not.
If you want to have Magnation Blue stats, feel free.
Yes.
What's going on in here?
Oh, Hansel's getting it on. Because it's so hot right now.
But it's not as steamy as... American Psycho.
Girl's trying to cock block.
Bad sister.
Who's coming out number four? Iron Man!
Iron Man.
Iron Man, historically unlucky.
Oh, it's John Cena!
Oh. Historically unlucky in Royal Rumble matches and in life in general when it comes to the Magnation. Spine Buster by Robin.
Well, Robin, that's gotta hurt your ego, Tony Stark.
Oh my God. Iron Man working on Robin, trying to take him out early.
He got suplexed by a 12-year-old boy.
Well, that would piss a person off, I'd assume.
And look, Robin already going for the elimination.
Oh
so
my God, Tony Stark, man! Shape up!
All right, Tony Stark fighting back at it.
There you go.
Buzz Lightyear, will he get eliminated?
Well, he's fighting Venom. Symbiote dealy.
All right, Buzz Lightyear staying in, and here comes our fifth competitor.
I just amended the superstar rating to include... titles that they've had. Waited, but he's won the title.
That's beautiful.
Robin eliminated.
Eliminated by Iron Man. Out comes Spawn.
Here comes Spawn.
Now Spawn on stage is at a disadvantage, but he's has every power in existence.
That puts Jack Six now in a one rating because he's had ranking.
True.
He's had two
in the picture, so. And Ash has only had one.
That's right. Among other things.
Iron Man now trying to eliminate Buzz Lightyear. The first two competitors in this matchup. Can Iron Man eliminate him?
Jack Six in first with 5.913. Ash with 5.901.
Uh-oh.
Yes, thousandths of a number.
Ash in an arms race with Jack Six.
With Master Chief at 5.003. So it's pretty much Ash and Jack Six right now.
Now, we've been trying to find a nice-looking Master Chief, but again, they look like dog shit in terms.
Dog shit. Here comes our sixth competitor.
Gambit!
Gambit. John Cena.
Out goes Buzz
Iron
Lightyear.
Man eliminated Buzz Lightyear.
He Iron Man already had two eliminations.
Yeah, maybe he's turning his look around here.
Well, they draft him very, very high, so hopefully he does.
That's true. He did take Iron Man. They 5-17 Iron Man.
Yep. Because he's kind of like in the same boat as Batman for me. He should win more. You know why? Because he's Iron Man.
Because he's Iron Man.
Because he's Iron Man. That guy just died.
Spawn and Venom working on each other. That's brutal right there.
That is brutal.
Spawn and Venom. We could be seeing... I don't know what they have.
Tony Stark!
Eliminating Gambit! That's three...
Three eliminations!
By Tony Stark. Here comes our seventh. Oh. Mega Man!
Oh, it's Mega Man! Now, Mega Man, I would assume, is very torn in this matchup. Because if he wins, he goes for a title, which is good. He's going against his... his good friend Vegeta. Because he did last night help out Vegeta by beating up the Joker. The Joker's still out. That's why he may or may not be in this match. I'm not sure. I did not check.
You didn't check the health conditions of your superstars?
What's the Joker?
But he's still one of your superstars. He's still one of your active members.
He is, but he was also kind of a dick, so.
It doesn't matter, you know, people like, you know, the Big Show are dicks, and you have to check on their well-being. And here
comes Tony Stark!
Leonardo.
Trying to take out Spawn, he got there!
All the eliminations have been done by Tony Stark!
He eliminated four people!
Half the field.
Holy crap! Here Tony Stark making a statement early on in this match.
The elimination brought to you by Stark Industries.
Tony Stark now working in Iron Man. Iron Man, that's not your fight, man. Tony Stark obviously on a whole other level right now. Is Leonardo working on Venom?
And Mega Man going...
Venom out!
Leonardo with the elimination. Mega Man not being able to get Tony Stark out of, out of this matchup.
Tony Stewart...
Tony Stewart!
Tony Stewart coming back this week, actually. Tony Stark certainly looks like a man on a mission so far in this match.
Here comes our ninth competitor into this 20-man rumble.
Almost halfway through already. Humming right on through.
Autobots.
Oh, it's Optimus Prime! What? Oh!
He has been gone for so long.
Surprise entrance.
Surprise entrance.
I don't even have his name on the step.
Oh, and he looks pretty good. Going right after Tony Stark.
It's gonna roll out, bitches.
That's right.
Autobots, roll out. Drop the beat.
Tony Stark already gone for a quick elimination on. To Optimus Prime.
Oh, Optimus, that's not how you would go out.
And Leonardo fighting Mega Man, both men fighting back into this matchup. They want that number one contender spot.
That's right. This is a star-making night right now for any of these people.
Oh, without a doubt.
Optimus not going to capitalize on Tony Stark being on the apron.
Because Optimus Prime hasn't done much as a singles competitor. He's mainly well-known for two things.
Leonardo eliminated by Mega Man!
Holy crap!
And here comes the Red Ranger!
Yeah, oh, Red Cthulhu Squirrel, Red Ranger!
Tenth?
What?
Hey, he's a squirrel and a Cthulhu. Oh.
Optimus Prime known for two things. Tag Team Title Reigns and murdering children.
Murdering children also on his resume.
Yes.
Yes.
The children?
Any of them.
Really the ones that ask him for his autograph.
So Optimus is a heel?
He was when he murdered children.
Yeah.
I can't quite speak for him now.
Yeah, I don't know if he still murders children. Red Ranger trying to eliminate Iron Man did not happen. Still working on him, though. Optimus Prime trying to eliminate Mega Man.
That'd be embarrassing if you couldn't eliminate little Mega Man, Optimus. Just gonna...
Your truck! There he goes!
You got it. Iron Man fighting into this matchup, not going down!
Iron Man has made it through over half of this Royal Rumble.
Here comes M. Bison.
He came out as number four.
And he's the longest running man in this one.
M. Bison representing La Pollution here. And this would be a big story if M. Bison were to win this. Considering that Captain Pollution legally cannot fight for that title.
No, he cannot.
As long as Vegeta's champion, he cannot fight for it. So this would be a way for Captain Pollution to maybe get back in the title on if M. Bison were to win.
Absolutely. But now, do you think M. Bison would just roll over and let Pollution take it?
I don't know. You might have a Triple H versus Batista type situation there.
Iron Man going to eliminate the Red Ranger here. Will he get him?
He got him!
Got him!
Fifth elimination for Iron Man.
Well,
holy crap.
Iron Man, you're working like a horse, but it doesn't count for anything in this matchup right now. Stat-wise.
Nope, not stat-wise, but Magnation Blue is the land of opportunity, and this is sure as shit getting you noticed. And here comes Michelangelo.
After his brother was just eliminated.
Trying to avenge his brother. Nice suplex by Iron Man.
He's been here a long time.
He came in at number 4.
The Ninja Turtles look really, really well done.
Yes.
They really do.
I'm so happy that someone made them as good as they did.
Indeed. Indeed. So I need to find people to start downloading.
Crap. We can always get Donatello. He's certainly available. You don't like purple? Optimus Prime trying to eliminate Iron Man. Iron Man stays in again.
Wow. And Bison working on Michelangelo, the younger of the Ninja Turtle brothers.
Man, it seems like years of futility has certainly been making up right now by Iron Man. Years of futility.
Here comes the Amazing Spider-Man. Just as the Amazing, but I know it's Spider-Man.
Yep.
I know.
In his new attire.
The Amazing attire.
I may have finally decided on attire because that one looks pretty prime.
The newer suit, too.
And that's the Spider-Man that I'm going for because I don't want the
Tobey Maguire crybaby.
Yeah.
Andrew Garfield, you did a fantastic job. I was sketchy at first about you, but you totally fucking nailed it.
Yeah. Dark Knight murdered those first two Spider-Man movies in my eyes.
Of course.
Because, like, going back and watching those, they just don't compare. They're just kind of corny.
They are very corny.
They have, like, frumpy school music in the team.
Spider-Man and Iron Man going for Optimus, but he fights back into this.
Wow.
Iron Man is trying to go almost the distance.
Yeah.
Okay, now we're...
Oh, Gypsy Danger!
Gypsy Danger, newly acquired.
Holy crap! This match.
Now we have our cap, so no one else is coming in this matchup.
Yes, this ring is currently at capacity due to weight limits.
Yeah, weight limits and safety restrictions.
Because look at the people in the ring.
We have a semi-truck.
We have a semi-truck. We have an Iron Man. We're going to have a 35...
Is he made of iron? Is that what that means?
No! He's actually not. He explains what the suit actually is at the end of the first movie.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't say that at the end of the credits.
It's not at the end of the credits.
Wasn't a big fan of the Iron Man movies.
Are you kidding me?
I liked Iron Man 1.
Iron Man 3 was the biggest pile of shit I've ever seen in my entire life.
Wow. I think I gotta watch Iron Man 3 again.
Both clips.
I love Iron Man 3.
I hate it.
Oh! Spider-Man just eliminated M. Bison!
But I will say the ending of the movie was cool with all the big fight scene.
Yeah.
But when they made Mandarin a joke, I wanted to walk out.
Well, that kind of disappointed a lot of people.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie.
I'm not going to lie. It
disappointed me a lot.
Iron Man fighting in this matchup!
Yeah, I was watching this video series of how to save Marvel, and they're like, why do we need to save Marvel? Oh, Iron Man trying to go for a 6th elimination! But yeah, the guy's like, look, name one villain in the Marvel movies. And the guy's like, Loki. He's like, alright, name another villain. And the guy's like, oh, shit.
Iron Man! Six eliminations
for Iron Man!
Wow.
He's going for the all-time Royal Rumble record, even though it doesn't mean anything in this.
It would be the unofficial record.
Yeah. He's done more in a smaller Royal Rumble than a lot of people have done in the full-size 40-man Royal Rumble.
Maybe he's invigorated because he has a chance now.
Yeah.
He's only got to survive 16 total people, not 36 total people.
Exactly.
Absolutely. Michelangelo quickly fighting back inside. Wow! Jumping clothesline, taking Iron Man off his feet. Spider-Man taking it to Gypsy Danger.
Number 15, Alucard!
Alucard,
the Crimson Fucker!
The 0-2 Alucard.
Soon to be 0-3, unless he can make it up for it right here.
Michelangelo going for the elimination on Tony Stark! Will he get
it? Uh-oh! Tony Stark teetering! Come on, Tony Stark!
And...
No! Oh, he stays in! What a run for Tony Stark in this match.
He bought his way into this matchup. Paid them all off.
Maybe. You never know with Tony Stark.
You don't.
Tony Stark working on Mikey in the corner.
He's just a man in a can.
And Mikey's actually had a nice performance in this Royal Rumble, too.
Absolutely.
Been around a while.
Yep.
I was going to say, with Spider-Man not working with Alucard to eliminate Gypsy Danger. Michelangelo hanging in this matchup. And here comes
Servo.
Servo.
From Superhuman Samurai. Oh my god.
I don't know what that is.
TV show, one of the Warren Brothers that is active in control, he looks cool.
Okay.
That's all you need to know.
Okay.
It's basically fights like, it's like the Power Rangers, except he fights in time and space.
Great.
It is great.
At some point I may have to watch an episode.
Absolutely. Iron Man in a corner.
Oh, man. Mikey working on Iron Man. Spider-Man working on Gypsy Danger. Alucard working on Servo.
And two out of the three men fought back. Well, Servo fought
Servo
back.
Teetering. Servo teetering. Servo teetering still. And he's out.
He's out.
Wow. All
right.
Piss poor performance by Servo. Oh, God.
Tony Stark in a predicament again.
Mikey working on Tony Stark yet again.
And Gypsy Danger working on Spider-Man. Spider-Man back in. Will
Spider-Man,
Tony
that's not your fight, man.
Will Tony Stark stay in this matchup?
Mikey's still working on Iron Man. Oh! Good run, Iron
Very
Man.
Very good run by good Tony run. Stark.
Six eliminations.
Absolutely.
What a run from Iron Man.
Absolutely.
And that will pay dividends later on.
Indeed. That might just put you in a mid-card.
Maybe.
Title well, hunt. Maybe.
It'll put him in something.
We'll see.
I'll find room for you somewhere, because remember, Magnation Blue. Land of Opportunity.
Land of Opportunity.
And you got Gypsy Danger still working on Spider-Man. Those two have been facing out for a long
Absolutely.
Time.
Absolutely. And Michelangelo eliminated
Alucard. I think that's his second elimination for him.
Yes, he eliminated Iron Man.
Oh, Alucard eliminated someone else. Servo. That's
what Yeah, that's what it was. That's what it was.
Mikey eliminated Iron Man. Yes. And Alucard getting saved.
Oh, wow! Man, the White Ranger!
Here comes the White Ranger. Trying to avenge the Squirrel's loss earlier in this match.
Sure, even though he's technically not a Cthulhu himself, he does respect his brethren.
That's right.
Regardless of species.
What he lacks in being a Cthulhu, he makes up for by just giving no shits at all.
Yes. He is absolute zero. Fuck shit.
Yeah. And talking about fucks given, Alucard working on Gypsy Danger.
Which is the number
Gypsy Danger trying to eliminate Alucard.
White Ranger trying to eliminate.
Not mad. But,
yeah.
Punches. Man. Fists. Fury.
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 Does anybody make Fury?
Probably.
I'm sure someone is.
I will probably download a Fury then.
Spoiler alert.
Samuel L. Jackson.
Spoiler alert.
Coming to Magnation Purple.
Spoiler alert.
Why?
Spoiler.
Why is it a spoiler?
Alert.
Number 18, Rorschach.
Rorschach. We haven't seen a lot of Rorschach in this Magnation time, but
no.
He is on the list here.
That's right. And can he make up White Ranger eliminating Spider-Man.
Son of a bitch.
Alucard with a nice run in this Royal Rumble. Same thing with Gypsy Danger.
He literally drop-kicked a 1,000-foot robot.
Well, Spider-Man suplexed him.
The balls of that.
The balls!
That means he had to jump at least 800 feet to drop-kick him.
Yeah, 800!
That is impressive.
What a shot from Gypsy Danger.
Oh, there he goes. Gypsy Danger teetering. Alucard.
White Ranger working on Rorschach in the corner.
We have many a dire straits.
And there goes Rorschach.
Thanks for coming out.
Wow.
That Royal Rumble appearance sums up Rorschach's Magnation career nicely.
Basically.
You were the weak link of the Watchmen.
You know, I'm going to get a Night Owl.
Oh, here goes Big Daddy.
Simply irresistible.
That's right.
Big Daddy, former hardcore champion. So he lost to the Tick. And then could not defeat the Tick.
That's right.
There you go.
Big Daddy working on Gypsy Danger, getting arm dragged.
Alucard teetering, White Ranger there. He's trying his damnedest.
Trying his damnedest.
Damnedest.
Damnedest. Big Daddy teetering.
Story of his
life.
Oh,
there goes Alucard from the White Ranger.
White Ranger. He's got two
Rangers. Hitting House.
Yeah.
Hitting House is the White Ranger. Saving Big
Daddy teetering.
It's springtime.
Big Daddy holding on.
And I believe here comes the last entrant.
Last entrant.
Could be anyone.
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 Might be me.
It's not you.
I know.
It's Dante.
Dante. Came up clutch in that 7-on-7 tag match some time ago.
That's right. He might become up clutch here too. Who knows?
Wire to wire, hitting Jack Six in the
head. Oh, the White Ranger eliminates Gypsy Danger.
Wow!
That was impressive to watch.
Down to our final three, Big Daddy, Dante, and the White Ranger. One of those three is fighting Vegeta at the next pay-per-view.
At the next pay-per-view. Double drop kick.
That is impressive.
Go, Dante! You're my world.
All right. All right, they're double teaming. Good moves.
And here's our final three. Dante, Big Daddy, and the White Ranger. Who will make it out of this?
Who do you got?
Oh, well,
Dante!
Dante's been in the Magnation for so long. Big Daddy coming off of a hardcore loss, and White Ranger coming off I think it was an Adam Wayne loss. But I'd say Dante's the emotional favorite in this.
What about the White Ranger?
White Ranger is a solid pick as well.
Sorry, Big Daddy, but you didn't impress me in the Watchmen. Or in Kick-Ass, you're not impressing me right now.
Well, he did get killed in that movie. Set on fire. Kerosene, no less.
Kerosene. Brutal.
Really shitty way to die.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. But he was Batman.
That's true.
He wasn't Batman.
That was really confusing during that Elimination Chamber where Batman and Big Daddy were both in it. Because I don't know if you've played Elimination Chamber matches, but they're really small.
And they look so much alike.
Yeah. So I'm kind of happy that since Big Daddy's in this match, he is not...
White Ranger taunting.
That means Big Daddy's not in line for a shot at the Magnation Championship. Magnation
no.
Blue. It's great news. But also seeing this, that means that Batman probably is.
Maybe.
Yeah, so anyone, don't get mad if the people that you see are not in this match. That means they're in bigger things.
Bigger and better things.
Land opportunity. Can't stress that enough.
So I think we've unofficially agreed that apparently I'm Magnation Purple.
Yeah.
I guess so.
That'll be interesting.
Indeed. So I'll have to pick 6 D-leaguers, and then how many for my own roster?
Oh, no, I can handle the D-league stuff. Oh,
okay.
And the roster is just whoever you want, really.
Okay. Fantastic. Fantastic. So once we get this D-league tournament out of the way, get ready.
Well, we have one more week in the second round, and then you have... Oh! Big Daddy trying to work on Dante with the White Ranger. Yeah, we have one more round in the second round, and then I think four more episodes, I think.
All right.
With Magnation, Team NXT, like 20 or 21 being like the last one before we move over to 14.
Dante in a precarious situation again. This time, both men working together.
This could be anyone's fight at this point. All three seem to be fairly even.
White Ranger's been the longest man in this matchup so far.
Yeah. He came in at number 17, I believe. Which shows just how opportunistic having a late draft pick is.
Absolutely.
Ooh,
chop block.
Even though, once again, hell of a run by Tony Stark.
Absolutely.
If he came in later, God knows what he would have done in this match. Because he was a man on fire. Oh, White Ranger teetering!
Both men working together, putting their differences aside for the time being to get rid of the longest run. Oh, wait!
White Ranger stays in!
And that alliance already broken.
Oh, yeah. Royal Rumbles are just chock full of loose alliances. Dante.
And there it is again.
Yep, double team onto the White Ranger.
Gut buster. That hurts. It's gotta hurt.
Oh, yeah.
At least he's not sparking all over the place when he gets hit.
No. That's the one thing that pissed me off about the Power Rangers. I was like, why do you got a spark, man? Why do you got a spark?
Why? What do you mean? All right. Dante saving the White Ranger. Just to put Big Daddy in the corner.
Uh-oh. And there goes Big Daddy!
The final two!
White Ranger or Dante, one of these two, is taking a huge step up the roster by facing Vegeta at the next pay-per-view.
Face Vegeta.
Pay-per-view still to be named.
Alright, headlocked. We're in an arm lock here. Alright, Dante coming out on top.
Dante whipping White Ranger in the corner. Could this be it right here? Nope. No cutscene. Tickling him. White Ranger shoves him off. Spinning heel kick connects. More tickling.
We don't do that here. Let's keep that calm.
Everyone loves tickle fights in Magnation Blue, apparently.
PG.
Oh, White Ranger teetering.
PG.
And there he goes!
Dante wins. Dante moves on to face Vegeta.
Huge. Huge win for Dante.
PG.
I to have Dante be the one person that took out the supremacy in that 7-on-7 tag team match, and now he finally gets some kind of due by getting this.
Absolutely.
It's been a long time coming for Dante in my book. I'm so happy that he got it.
Magnitude, you happy?
Oh, yeah.
Where did he go?
Magnitude had to go bowling. So he gracefully left.
Gracefully? All right. Fair enough.
It's all right. I think we only got, like, one more match after this.
Like, Christian, one more match.
One more match. It's gonna make me so sad when he loses. He's gonna come in like second to last. I'm gonna be bummed out.
Oops.
You know, I do love Christian. I just know it's not happening. Poor Christian. Oh, and here we go. Another Elimination Chamber qualify match. Sub-Zero versus the Cookie Monster. Now, I feel like I don't even have to ask you who you're pulling for in this.
No. No, you don't. God. Damn it!
And Sub-Zero suffering just such a brutal loss at the hands of Ash Ketchum last night. It was it pained me to see that match end just because I knew that one of those two people were losing.
Yeah.
But someone had to win, and unfortunately this guy came up short. And that is a new look Sub-Zero.
I'm liking it. I am liking it.
Still wearing his pay-per-view attire.
Can you believe that they're making a sequel to this movie?
Why?
This movie's just a huge pile of garbage.
Apparently it must have done something. Never know.
Anyway.
Yeah, Sub-Zero.
Coming into the ring. Fresh off a loss.
And this would be a great way to get him back in the title hunt pretty immediately.
Absolutely.
If you win this, you go straight to the Elimination Chamber to join Jason and Ash Ketchum.
To compete for number one contendership or compete for a belt?
Compete for the belt.
All right, then.
Straight for the Magnation Blue title. You win this, you are in that match.
Great.
Great. And here comes the Cookie Monster.
Let's dodge me down that dirt sea.
You can see his face.
Right.
You ready?
Trevor!
You ready?
Jump!
Time's it. It's the main time! Woo! God damn, I hate my life.
Best in the street! I finally get to the top rope.
You're going too early. You gotta do it, you gotta do it right! I had a whole thing synchronized, in the like when he first started doing it. It just kept getting more and more elaborate. And now it's devouring time, and then the woo, and then the best in the street.
Why the woo?
I don't know. I have no good explanation as to why there's a woo.
Nom, cookie.
Justin Roberts not caring at all.
Cookie.
Instead of a devouring, it should be cookie time. First of all.
I was trying to go for a comparison to clobbering.
Alright.
So, to the clobbering is devout.
Best in the streets, I did that.
Yep.
Best in the streets.
It's kind of like that scene from Return of the Jedi, except terrible.
And
with witches.
And decapitations.
In this movie, we play witches.
Great.
That was one of my favorite things from the Anchorman 2 trailer back in the day.
Yeah.
Oh, they had like these promo trailers where it was just Brick just being an idiot.
Okay.
So like they all did their promo lines and Brick's like, in this movie, we play witches.
Nice.
Nice. Sub-Zero and Cookie Monster. Two people that really represent what Magnation Blue is.
Do they even have a history with each other?
I don't think so. Because like Sub-Zero, Cookie Monster's been primarily a single wrestler. I don't know if he's ever done a tag team. Fans, feel free to correct me, but I am the encyclopedia. And Sub-Zero has been primarily, up to this point, a tag team wrestler. So it's really cool to see these two have a singles match right here.
I gotcha. And Cookie Monster, definitely already out of the block on top of Sub-Zero.
Yeah, because Cookie Monster absolutely has the experience. And that's one thing that Sub-Zero lacks. Nice neck breaker. And I think that's something that's going to come in time with Sub-Zero.
Well, I think Sub-Zero's fighting style is a lot different than, you know, obviously being in a squared circle with rules.
Yeah. And the ability that he cannot use, like, ice blasts or anything.
Yeah, that's terrible. That's a terrible thing to waste.
But, yeah.
Now they're suplexing back and forth. Trying
there you
to,
go. Oh, the swift kick connected!
It actually
it
worked!
Connected! Oh, my God!
Impressive.
Yeah, I think the same guy that created the reptile and the scorpion created
probably
this guy.
Yep, makes sense.
So, like, whoever did that, good looks on you. Absolutely. For creating these three, because holy crap, they look good.
Absolutely. Nice suplex there by Sub-Zero.
Now, for the people that were crying about reptile not having the same attire in the reptile match, Magnitude can only find that one. I have the other one on my thing still. I didn't delete him. He still exists. He still looks awesome. So the funny feet one will exist on his thing. But
funny feet. One.
Well, yeah, he had really funny feet. But yeah.
Wow, soup kick missing.
Since Mortal Kombat won the tag team championships, they have moved over to Magnation Blue.
Ah.
Which means that, oh, that's good news.
That's good news for you.
Yeah. Especially with Tick being as hot as he is. I now have two out of the three titles that I could possibly win that are cross-branded.
Nice.
The Attaway title eluding me still. His Ash Ketchum came up short in the qualifying match.
So you're like a triple crown right now. If what you're saying for belts, you're triple crown right now.
One away. All I need is the Attaway.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
And that'll be a big hit to Magnation Green.
Absolutely. Sub-Zero drop kicking no one.
Drop kicking the air, trying to, I don't know, exert his dominance, yep. But he kind of missed.
The wily veteran Cookie Monster, God help me for saying that, because I... But he's been in the Magnation for a while at this point.
He has.
A one-time hardcore champion, moving up, potentially. He had that one match against, I believe it was Jason Voorhees, an Inferno match for the Galactic title. Came up short in that. My battery's running low.
Battery's running low, 10%.
Okay.
We're
going to have to improvise here. First off, give me the microphone. Doing this on the fly!
On the fly, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, now we're going to move the microphone over here.
Okay.
Now give me the laptop.
Here comes the laptop. Oh, wait.
Sub-Zero coming back. Sub-Zero.
Wow.
Clothesline. And we're good.
We are good.
And we're going to move it here.
All right. There we go.
Yeah. Oh! Got a Hell's Gate, I believe, on Cookie Monster.
All right, but he fought out of it.
Yes, he did.
Fought out of it.
Now, Sub-Zero working on Cookie Monster some more. Oh, getting switched up.
Wow, knees to the face.
That is not bode well.
Now, quick kick.
For Sub-Zero.
Cookie Monster being the dominant force in this matchup.
I'd never thought I'd see the day.
Me neither. Oh, nice counter by Sub-Zero.
Sub-Zero staying in it, trying to hit that deep freeze neck breaker.
Deep freeze neck breaker!
And Cookie Monster going for a little bit of a...
Cookie vice? I don't know.
Looks like an octopus or something.
The cookie cutter?
An abdominal stretch, perhaps?
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Well, Cookie Monster does have the Anaconda Vice as a secondary finisher called the Cookie Crumble.
Oh, Cookie Crumbler. I kind of like Cookie Cutter better, but Crumbler works too.
Yeah, they're both good.
Indeed.
And then side slam. Sub-Zero gets out of it, trying to mount some kind of comeback here. Because this is
on the line for a title opportunity.
Oh, he's going for, wow!
That's
illegal, but it sure as shit helps.
Yeah, absolutely. He held it for a good 2 seconds before breaking it. Good sportsmanlike conduct.
Well, he did have till 5.
Right. Right.
As Daniel Bryan will certainly let you know in the ROH.
Indeed.
Oh, deep freeze neck breaker.
Deep freeze
neck breaker. Could that be it? One, two. Oh!
Wow, so close. 2 3/4.
The heart of Cookie Monster getting out of that.
The wily veteran.
Oh! Cookie Monster trying to go for the go to street! The go to street! Connecting and it busts him open! Oh my goodness. What a win this would be for Cookie Monster
right here. Chewie's on my side. Chewie's growling right now.
One! Two! Oh! He kicked out! He kicked out! Oh, this is another match where I'm so torn.
Wow! Nice floating DDT.
Because I've adored Cookie Monster for a long time, even as a kid. But I do love me some Sub-Zero. MMA bows!
Dem bones. Dem bows. Now, I've always liked Cookie Monster, too. Just not this CM Punk knockoff Cookie Monster. And Sub-Zero was always my go-to Mortal Kombat combatant.
He was one of them for me.
I always figured Scorpion was overrated. Liu Kang, overrated.
Yep. Raiden, how'd you feel about Raiden?
Raiden was all right, but he was the cheapest person to use.
True.
All you had to do was do the flying, like, punch, like, spring.
What? Connects. Could that be it? Nope.
Nope. Quick.
The Dean Ambrose, nope.
Yeah, nope.
Oh, my God.
Back of the head.
That might
Sub-Zero
have knocked
might
out
be
Sub-Zero.
Knocked out.
Cover. One. Two.
Oh, wow, not even a two count.
Fold over DDT. Take a drink.
Wow.
Another cover. Cookie Monster absolutely trying to capitalize.
Two. And no, Sub-Zero still fighting out of it. Sub-Zero not going out without a fight because he knows what's on the line.
Yeah. A shot at the Magnation Blue Championship.
Wow, what a clothesline. Could this spell the end for the Cookie Monster?
Maybe.
Wait, he's going to...
Connects again.
Again.
Trying to set the deep freeze neck breaker.
Will he get it?
Gets reversed. Into the ropes!
Oh, wow.
Into his own neck breaker.
Cookie Monster, will this be it?
Oh, the camel clutch!
Will Seth
trying to make him humble. He has nowhere to go!
He got him! Kidding me!
And now Cookie Monster has a 1-6 chance at winning the Magnation Blue Championship.
I hope Vegeta blasts you to oblivion.
Oh, he's not facing Vegeta.
Good.
He is in the match so far with Ash Ketchum and Jason Voorhees.
And who's the champion?
Ash Ketchum.
Oh, well, I've gotten confused then. My bad.
And this is right up Ash Ketchum's alley because he does have the most eliminations in Elimination Chamber history at, I believe, 6.
Well, good. Then I hope Ash Ketchum critical hits you and puts you in a Pokeball. You stupid, stupid monster. I love him, Cookie.
Oh, man. Poor Sub-Zero, he had nowhere to go in that match
at
that point.
Not. Absolutely not. So then who's Vegeta facing? We haven't
figured
that
out. Oh, no, Vegeta's facing Dante.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Duh. Wow. Hey, welcome to keeping your memory fresh.
It's all right. That's what the encyclopedia is here for.
Absolutely.
All right, so I believe that's it for Magnation Blue.
You sure?
Pretty sure.
I don't heard any news. So, this is it, ladies and gentlemen.
Yep, Q with the Iron Sheik tweet of the day, looking on Twitter right now. Iron Sheik. Oh, he's angry.
He's always angry.
He's not thrilled.
Not at all. Oh, man.
All right, here, Iron Sheik tweet. Oh, what the hell's this?
What's going on?
Oh, no.
No?
That fucking music. Oh, come on!
What the hell?
You lost!
Get over it, you baby!
And you're still using his entrance!
What?
You beat him once!
Once!
Well, technically, three times. You beat him three times.
It's time to go back to your own entrance.
I know.
Not that good.
Damn it, Pollution! What the hell is he even out here for? He's not scheduled.
No.
That was the last match!
This is your show! You were losing control?
Him and I are going to have to talk.
Talk to him?
I have dinner reservations.
Dinner reservations?
Yep.
Nice.
Yeah, going to Bertucci's.
Delicious.
I know.
Good stuff.
Might bring Dante.
All right. Well, Chewy not happy with Pollution.
Apparently not.
Chewy not happy with Pollution.
But really, who is?
Nobody. Why you look like you're about ready to wrestle?
This is a load of Pollution? It was a polluting
flu. Wow, the pun's not necessary.
Well, I guess he can't curse.
Why not?
I don't know. Because he's a cartoon character?
Was there, are we PG?
No, we're not PG.
Exactly, because our commentary's not very PG.
He's a polluting flu. I'm the best no one can touch my polluting ass. Polluting ass.
Wow. Wow.
Strong words.
Strong words from an angry loser.
Very. The salt that is permeating from Captain Pollution right now.
You couldn't get the job done.
He is issuing an open challenge to anyone in back.
Look, you couldn't get the job done last night. Just deal with it.
Who's seriously.
Who's going
to answer that call? I don't know that music.
Me neither.
I don't know these lights. Okay, who the hell is it?
Ready, no matter who it is.
Oh! It's Boo! Oh my god! Oh, business is picked up.
Boo is back and he looks ready to go.
He is ripped. And he is flipping pissed at Pollution and he has a reason too.
Absolutely.
Because for those of you not up to speed, Captain Pollution was the one ipso facto that got Boo and the rest of his crew gone. Because Pollution's the one that agreed to that 7-on-7 tag team match in the first place.
You know, looking at this, it looks like Boo must have lived with Brock Lesnar. Look at his face.
Oh, yeah.
It looks like Brock Lesnar.
A little bit.
He got rid of the head. He kind of toned down his tail.
Yeah, he seems to have been hitting the gym here. He seems a lot more focused and,
Oh, looks like the fans are happy to see Boo as
Absolutely.
Well.
I'm happy to see anyone really that wants to fight Pollution. He's a friend in my book. Yeah, that's true. But I am very much in favor of Pollution beating the, getting the crap beaten out of him by
absolutely.
Boom.
Absolutely.
Oh, man. I am hyped. He is hyped.
Wow.
Oh, man. Wow. What a match we have in our unexpected main event.
Even Justin Roberts is happy.
Who wouldn't? It's been a long time since Boo's been around.
Pollution probably regretting his decision right about now.
I would imagine.
Right about now.
Because now he's about to step in the ring with this guy.
And I would have.
Wow, a new look, Boo. Looking to come in and stir up some trouble here.
Looking for payback.
Absolutely.
So let's see how long Boo makes work.
And here we go.
Pollution.
Oh, my God. What a match.
Pollution starting it off because he obviously is not happy to see Boo
again.
Wow. Taking his legs out from underneath him.
It's those boxing gloves. Oh, my God.
Rapid punches. Pollution counter. Jump kick. Miss
Isaguri! Huge shot.
Absolutely. Now, drop kick.
Pollution by far has the most ring experience right now because I'd imagine that Boo, after being out for so long, has a lot of ring rust.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So to come back against this caliber of wrestler, tall task for Boo.
But I think Boo can pull it off.
Absolutely. Boo getting the waist lock. Thrown into the corner by Pollution. Pollution trying to end this early because he knows that he was in a hell of a battle against Vegeta like earlier on Sunday.
Right, and he's Boo knows this, so he's probably not 100%, so Boo wants to take advantage of that.
That's right. He got beat in a ladder match to win the title. Absolutely.
Well,
like,
he went through three matches, so one of them being Hell in a Cell, which is the one he won, correct?
Yep. Fan's not a fan of the Hell in a Cell, but they're computers. They're dumb.
They are dumb.
Funny enough, those were the first three matches that I simmed too.
Yep.
First shot on each of them, and it turned out going seven games. And that ladder match is really a classic in my book.
Good.
The amount of drama at the end of that match.
Right.
Huge.
But again, as we mentioned on Magnation Green earlier this week, it doesn't compare to the Goku Yusuke match, Three Stages of Hell title match.
Oh, that's an all time classic.
Drama, everything.
Higher stakes, too.
Absolutely.
That's for the main belt.
Yes.
Neck breaker by Pollution. Pollution absolutely has the upper hand right now. This is not the return that Boo would have liked.
I'm sure Boo will bring it back. Like you said, lots
of... Oh, and that's a good start. Holy crap.
All right. Lock up. Boo coming out on top or behind.
Sweeping the legs again. Using those clubbing boxing gloves.
Clubbing boxing gloves. Into the corner, Irish Rip, drops the axe on Pollution, quickly goes out of the way.
Ooh, hell of a kick right there by Pollution. Hell of a kick. Pollution going around back again. Nice suplex. Shows domination.
Absolutely.
Pollution still peppering him with those kicks. Oh, nice kick there by Pollution. That certainly will jar you.
Indeed, indeed, indeed.
Pollution whipping Blue in the corner. Headbutt.
Wow.
Shoulder block. Knocks the wind out. Oh, my God!
Looks like a Rolling Thunder type move.
Holy crap. They're in the corner.
Who being adaptable and rubbery. You can only imagine this doesn't do that much damage to him.
No. But I'd certainly say that this is pissing him off, because once again, like...
Yeah.
He figured this would probably be a cakewalk to have a Pollution that... Not at full strength. He's at full strength, although very rusty, apparently. And he is getting taken to town right now by Pollution. Not the return he had in mind. Oh, but that's a good way to come back again.
Again.
Come on, Boo. This is how you teach him right here.
Punches, just flurries of punches and kicks, Boo. Nothing fancy, just get it done.
Yeah, especially since after the match, Pollution freaking beat up Spider-Man with two of his cronies, Zangief and Jesus, that were in that 7-on-7 tag match.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you'd think that one of those two men would come to help Boo.
That would come to help Pollution? Well, Zangief got drafted onto Magnation Green, and they, if you remember from the Facebook Royal Rumble, Zangief apparently still has beef with Pollution because he beat the crap out of him in there.
Indeed, indeed.
And Jesus currently fired. You only saw him in the Christmas match.
Yep, because it's Christmas.
That's right.
Spirit of the holiday.
Of course. He's Jesus. You got to have him in a Christmas match.
Indeed.
Float over DDT. Take a drink.
Boo. You gotta come on, Boo. You got to step up your game.
Yeah, this This is not the way I saw this going at all. Back body throw.
Nice counter by Majin Buu.
And Buu, former Magnation champion, I think, maybe two-time?
I'm not sure.
He beat Yusuke Urameshi in a classic, classic battle. And that's how he actually showed up. Showed up, murdered Link, took the title.
Great.
Oh, yeah. He did a lot of crap. Like, and he deserved his firing. Absolutely. But maybe he's come back as a changed man. Who knows?
Well, who knows?
If he wants to beat up Pollution instead of aligning with him, that's a great way to start in my book.
And there's a moonsault by Pollution. Standing moonsault.
Pollution still taking it to him. Back fist! Back fist to the future. Eddie Kingston's finisher. Good to have you back, Chikara. One! Kick out by Buu. And now Buu, again, just anything at this point would be nice for Buu. Because he is just... Oh, there you go, clothesline. He's trying to at least make this an even matchup, because right now Boo's been getting spanked. Another takedown by Pollution. Oh, he's going him up for, I believe, the Force of Illusion.
The Force of Illusion.
Nope. Oh!
Wow.
What a slam.
With authority, he put him down.
And that might be it.
That might be it. Boo might be out.
Count. Brother, one.
And then Boo, no, wow.
Yeah, Bootley's showing some heart here, staying in this match.
Irish whip in the corner, doing some damage.
Oh! German with a bridge! That might be it!
One! Oh, wow.
Nice move right there by Pollution.
Oh, yeah.
I'm impressed with Pollution in this match. I gotta give the devil his due.
Yeah, but if Magic is here, he would not agree with you.
Well, no, because he punched him in the dick and sent him to the hospital. If someone punched me in the dick, I would not be their fan either.
Punched in the dick.
And sent to the Go Crew Hospital.
The Go Crew.
The Go Crew Hospital. The Go Crew was beaten up at such a high point by the Boo Crew at one point that they had their own hospital.
Wow.
With a tab that Magnitude went to. Oh! Thrown out of the ring!
Come on, Boo!
Oh, this is no good at all. Oh my god!
With authority!
And now Boo absolutely taking advantage after that. Holy crap, what a shot that was.
Oh, yeah.
Lifted him up. What is this? Oh, my God.
Jeez.
A jumping tombstone on the outside.
That's brutal. Get him. Just get in the ring and let him stay there, Boo.
Jesus. Boo, at this point, just trying to punish him.
I think that's all this was supposed to be to begin with.
Yeah.
Just punish me.
And he's setting him up for the Boo Ball.
The Boo Ball.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
And that should do it.
We can only hope.
Drag him to the ring. Cover. One. No. Pollution fights out. Pollution showing heart. Because that is one of the things that makes him Captain Pollution.
Heart? No, I mean Captain Planet, not Captain Pollution.
Well, yeah, I don't know.
Come on now.
Maybe hatred? Yeah, showing hatred.
There you go. Up on the top of the head.
That is one of my favorite submissions. Just like the leg scissors just to punch him in the face.
Nice takedown by Boo. A quick stomp. And an elbow drop.
There you
the
go,
face.
Boo. This is the Boo I come to know and, well, not loved at the time, but I like him now.
Indeed.
Pollution going up. Springboard! Misses! Could that be the opening Boo needs? Dragging him up. Setting up for maybe that jumping tombstone again. Got him!
Wow. With authority. One.
Could that be it? One. Two. No.
Oh, wow. Pollution still with such fight.
Oh! Setting up for the Boo Ball. Got all of it.
Oh, man.
Holy crap.
I think he's got to be out.
I'd be out.
He's got to be out.
Can this be it? One, two, three. And welcome back, Boo. Getting the win in his comeback. Woo!
What a match.
Now, I don't know what this means for the future between the two, but...
You know that there's going to be history.
Yeah, Boo came back and absolutely made a statement saying, I am here and I do not like you.
And with Belushi being out of the title run, as long as Vegeta holds that title, you can honestly say that there is going to be a vicious rivalry brewing between these two superstars.
One can only hope.
Right now.
And I certainly should pay money to see that.
Absolutely. But now, does this mean back to the current supremacy?
Oh!
Or will it still be, will it not be a supremacy anymore?
Boy, who knows? I mean, like, the fact that he came back, anything can happen at this point.
Freddie Jones here again?
I think so. This is absolutely a different Boo than we've ever seen, but I am happy that he's around and beating up Captain Delusion.
Indeed, I'm sure Magnitude would be thrilled as well.
Magnitude saluting him from heaven as we speak.
Missing the return of Boo.
I'm sure he's
Bowen.
Yeah, I actually texted him during this, and he is not pleased that he's not here. All right, good night, everyone. We'll see you next week.
Good night.